Tranexamic acid for hyperpigmentation can be a great solution, especially if you've been struggling with dark spots, discoloration, and melasma. And chances are you've probably already tried products like vitamin C or even hydroquinone at one point to fade away dark spots, but maybe haven't found any luck. Is it then time to try tranexamic acid? Well, if you don't know, tranexamic acid has gained a lot of popularity as one of the newest dark spot treatments on the market, and I think it's important that we mention in this video everything that you need to know about tranexamic acid serum so you can start fading away those dark spots as soon as possible. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as being the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you guys to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you find any value in this video, then consider subscribing as well. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. What is tranexamic acid? Now, tranexamic acid is a synthetic analog of the amino acid lysine and has been used to treat or stop excessive loss of blood in various situations, including major trauma and surgery. And in 1979, they discovered that one of its side effects was actually lightening up dark spots on the skin, which paved the way for skincare manufacturers to start incorporating tranexamic acid as a solution for dark spots. And many people have been able to see an improvement in their discoloration just by adding it into their regimen at around the 8 to 12 week mark, which is amazing. And how it works is really interesting because it's great at targeting hyperpigmentation, whether it be post-inflammatory or from hormonally induced melasma. Because if you take a look at one of the causes of dark spots, you find a lot of times it actually comes from UV light, which activates plasmin, which then activates tyrosinase activity, which then produces melanin pigments that we want to avoid. But when we use tranexamic acid, we find that it blocks this first pathway, which is great, the UV-induced melanin synthesis, by stopping the interaction between our keratinocytes, which are our skin cells, and our melanocytes, which are our melanin-producing skin cells. So if you stop that, you stop dark spot formation. And the best part is that it's very gentle and works well with other ingredients because it doesn't exfoliate or stimulate collagen. So you can use it with your vitamin C, retinol, niacinamide, and kojic acid, which I've made videos on all of them linked down in the description below that I encourage you to watch as well. So now that we define what tranexamic acid is and how it works, let's talk about how to use it and layer it. Many of the products you find either come in a serum or a moisturizer, but you could also find it in a peel as well. And the ideal concentration to look for is between 3% and 5%. And you could start by using it once a day to see how your skin reacts to it. Now, if you're starting it in the morning, start by using a gentle facial cleanser, then your vitamin C serum, then layer on the tranexamic acid after it and follow up with an SPF of 50 or more. It's super important you don't forget the sunscreen because without it, you'll reverse a lot of the progress you've already made. And what's awesome is that when you combine it with vitamin C, this is gonna help maximize those brightening effects because essentially what you're doing is maximizing the strength against the tyrosinase enzyme to stop making more pigment, and you're doing that with two products. And let's say if you're using a retinol or a retinoid at night, then go ahead and layer it under your preferred retinoids and retinol to get an extra kick at night for overall improved skin tone and texture as well. Now, as far as which products, so for the vitamin C, go with the least expensive one that produces the best results, which I've mentioned before on this channel, the 10% L-ascorbic acid by CeraVe. And then layer it with the Paulas Choice 3% tranexamic acid, especially if it's your first time, since going straight to 5 can cause dryness, irritation, and a little bit of flakiness as well. The Paulas Choice Discoloration Repair Serum has the 3% tranexamic acid, 5% niacinamide, and 0.5% bakuchiol, along with vitamin E and milk thistle to improve the look of those dark spots at the 8 to 12 week mark. And what's really cool is that the bakuchiol in it can be a great alternative to anyone looking to replace retinol if, let's say, you had a bad reaction to retinol and can't tolerate it. It's essentially a monoterpene phenol and it's a functional analog of retinol, and at the 12 week mark of using bakuchiol, significant improvements in photo damage on the skin has been seen, as well as the skin firmness and elasticity improvement, which are all amazing. But keep in mind that with the discoloration repair serum, start with 3 times a week and work up to 2x a day to give your skin that time to adjust, and don't forget the sunscreen along the way. Click that red subscribe button down below if you found any value, and I'll see you on the next one.